Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the North Carolina Tar Heels and the Duke Blue Devils. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our Star Watch for today's game. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
I like the matchup for small forward position. These two players must lead their team out and show the way. Yes, dictate the way this game is played.
All right, buckle up, folks. Here we go.
As we tip into the first half, the butterflies are flying, baby.
The Tar Heels are number five in the polls right now, Dick.
Out there, Brad, it's always great to see how the rankings change from week to week. The parity in college basketball is unbelievable.
He attempts to dribble around the trap. Unsuccessful, though.
Hey, trap's giving that kid some fits.
Trying to feed inside. We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock. Perfectly executed. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Swatted away. On the left side. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Off the glass and no good. Meeks, pump fakes. Goes up for two. He drains the bucket. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. In the lane.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Number 30 is whistled for the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
As we take a look at the sophomore.
Brad, he's got that first year of experience under his belt. So this season, his team is going to be looking for him a lot more.
Makes them both. Two-man action. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. From right in the circle and score it. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Screen. He tries the jumper. Can't connect. Looks at the three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Jumper. When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a little bit easier, wouldn't you say, Dick?
When you combine those two skills, the floor looks a lot wider for everyone on your team.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. working around the perimeter.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Johnson receives the ball. Tries one from three-point land. Gets the J to fall.
And the fans love it. Jump with joy, fan. Hey, that's my guys yelling.
He shoots the jumper for two. Makes it.
Get out of the way, baby. That was absolutely sensational.
He looks for three. Buries the fadeaway. On the outside. Johnson's modest play is having a negative effect on his composure emotionally. He couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
Hey, he may need some encouragement from one of his teammates.
Jumper. Missed the jumper. On the left side. And the ball is saved. Great job. Robinson handles the feed. He goes up with it. Jumper won't go. Gave it up. From left of the circle, perfectly executed. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Working around the perimeter. With the jumper. Bust the J. Look at him move the ball, Dick.
Hey, when each player on offense touches the ball on the perimeter, it forces the defense to move. Eventually, the defense will break down.
Moving it around the perimeter. The jumper. Here comes the ball screen. Meeks picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. Hey, a player's senior year is such an emotional one. The key is to stay focused and not get caught up on being in your last year of collegiate basketball. If you focus on the right things, win or lose, it'll be a memorable experience.
Both free throws go. They've got him trapped. Johnson receives the pass. Pushes it up. Takes the jumper. And score it. For the bucket. It's good. Turnover committed by the senior. On the outside. Tries for two. He gets it to fall. There's a double team waiting there. Lobs it. Goes up for two. Ingram getting after it and saves it. For two. He missed. Too much. That's a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
Knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful is a big bonus.
This game's really living up to its billing as these two rivals are competing at a very high level.
This is what you come to expect in games like this, Brad, with so much pride at stake. Yes, both these teams are going to be laying it all on the line for the entire game.
The Blue Devils are on the run. On the dribble, gives it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender. On the left side. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from downtown. Missed it. Number five handles the feed. And we've got a change in possession here. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
The Blue Devils move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get...
Gets the rejection. Ingram receives the pass. He launches a three. He nails the bucket. Takes his jumper. The missed shot. And now getting set up here to four round one.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
It's no good. Tickles a twine. This guy's really known as more of a power guy.
Well, when he gets positioning in the paint, it's usually game over for the opposition.
He goes for three. Off the mark. Allen handles the pass. He tries the three. Knocked it down. Let's check out this three-pointer one more time, Dick. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad foul right there, Brad.
Out on the wing. Fed the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. He misses the J. Buried it. Wow, partner, this crowd is something else when it gets going.
These fans love it, baby. They're more than a sixth man. This crowd is like a whole other team in the stands. This is what college basketball is all about.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Knocks it down. The deep shot from outside. Missed the jumper.
spacing.
He tries the three ball. What should they do here, Dick?
I'd call a timeout and see what's going on out there. There's definitely some miscommunication happening.
Around 8 minutes remaining. They work the perimeter. The freshman has a brain cramp there and commits a turnover. Turnover committed by the freshman. Johnson receives the ball. Puts up the J and come up short. Pushes it up. Here's a double team. With a bucket. And he misses the shot. Out on the wing. We're at the 7 minute mark. He attempts the jump shot. Gets the J to fall. He draws the foul. Looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
They will line him up. Hits the first shot. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones. Converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
Number 12 makes his debut into the game.
I tell you, this kid comes in with fire, Brad. He really knows how to bring it.
They've got him right where they want him, Richard. The crowd continues to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man.
He throws it up from downtown. Off the mark. Williams receives the ball. They push it up on the break. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Number 5 takes the feed. Gave it up. Tries for 2. Great shot.
Unusual mistake there by the senior.
The Tar Heels are on the run. Goes up for 2. He hits the shot. It on the floor and up and under. Nope.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
Working it around the perimeter. About 5 minutes remaining. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Down inside. He puts up the J. Nails the J. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Jumper won't go.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
For 2. That was nice. They'll bring it back out on top and reset it.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box. I hate it when guys can't make that entry.
4 minutes left on the game clock. Jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
They'll work it around the arc. Looks at a three. Off the mark. Williams handles the feed. For the bucket. Gets it to go.
Up and inside.
Tries for two. Oh, yes. About 3 minutes remaining. Number five takes the feed. They get it to go. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Buries it. Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the deep corner. Can't get the shot to go. Goes up with it. Nails a sweet jumper. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Out on the wing. He tries the jumper. Busts the J. We're at the two-minute mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up with a shot. Can't connect. On the right side.
Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
And a momentary look from three-point land. He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. There was no doubt about that one. For two, scorches the net. On the dribble, gives it up. He pulls the trigger. We're at the 1 minute mark. Off the mark. Johnson receives the pass. He goes up with it. Nails the J.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Jones comes up with it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
With the jumper. Jumper won't go. He gets the bucket. They work it around the perimeter. Trying to beat the buzzer. Missed it. At the end of the first half, the Blue Devils lead by 11. Duke really did a great job of collecting the boards in the first half, Dick.
Hey, collecting the boards and canceling out second chance opportunities, that's how you win ball games, baby.
While we get a moment here, let's take a look at the keys for each of these teams today.
I've been really impressed with just how hard both teams are playing. These numbers show you how they've been performing.
Number 34 is put back in the game.
Hey, this team easily comes apart without him out there, Brad.
Let's go courtside for a comment regarding this rivalry. Aaron?
Well, you got to have momentum coming out of halftime. Both coaches stressed this to their respective teams. The first few possessions will be very important and will set the tone. This game is far from over, Brad.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. I'll let you know that with an additional insight there. On the left side. For the bucket. Can't get it to go. Gave it up. Throws it up. He rejects it. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper and come up short. They work it around the perimeter. Bad decision there by the senior. In the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it. He shoots from outside. Nope. Robinson handles the pass. Number 34 is called for the foul. Third personal foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Well, Dick, here's a player in just his freshman year.
Hey, being a student in college is quite an experience. But being a student athlete is something on a whole other level. There are a lot of challenges you have to meet if you want to keep your balance and be successful.
And he got them both. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad.
Tries for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. He gets that one to fall. Williams receives the ball. Busts the jumper. On the outside. Commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He is going to the line. Gets his first.
Free throws can. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. He nails the shot. Cross court. Number 30 is charged with the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line for the first time. First one, good. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Two at the charity stripe. Robinson receives the ball. The missed shot. Johnson receives the pass. He manages to keep it in play. And we'll get a change of possession. The inbound play on the baseline. Moving it around the perimeter. For two. Gets it to fall. the left side. A little two-man action.
There's the trap.
For the bucket. He drains the shot.
That was absolutely phenomenal.
On the outside for three.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Now that's what I call showtime.
You better believe it, baby.
The student body is rocking tonight.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
Trying to pack it inside. Drains it. On the right side. Looking for a good shot. He makes the block. Pushes it up. Alley-oop. He gets the rejection. Gets the J to fall. He shoots from the corner. The Blue Devils have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Ratty's on fire.
On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper. They got it. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Trying to feed the low block. Turnaround jumper. Missed the jumper. On the right side. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. That's good. Turnover by the senior. Steals the ball. Receives the pass. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Tries a three, knocked it down.
Look at that spacing.
It looks as if, and it's blocked. Got it. That move was uncontested.
There's simply no urgency on defense, Brad.
Gave it up. Goes up. Can't connect. Out on the wing. They work the perimeter. With the jump hook. Off the mark. Pushes it up. With a great block.
The last line of defense is a good block.
Thank you. come up short. Johnson handles the pass. From beyond the arc. Jumper won't go. Robinson receives the ball.
Backcourt violation called.
Little bit of a mental lapse by the offense that time, Dick. Rivalry's the theme. Let's go courtside to EA, Aaron Andrews. Aaron Andrews, you've got one of the best viewpoints in the whole building, and what wasn't a game has become a great one.
Well, we have a close one now, guys. In a rivalry game, you always expect some heroics. It's a great chance for players to step up and make plays. This is what we've been waiting for. Now it's on, and the blood is boiling. I'm expecting a great finish now.
Thanks, Aaron. Inside, puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
Yeah, it is pretty similar.
Wow. I didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
Working it around the perimeter. Goes up with it. And score it. He takes a three. Scorches the net with a J. Takes the
great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter my lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
They'll work it around the arc. He attempts the jump shot. Nails the jumper.
Up and inside.
He wants a three. Nails the J. On the low block, he puts up the J. Busts the jumper. The Tar Heels often recruit really athletic players, and they aren't afraid to travel the globe to find them.
They like guys who can really get up and down the court. Their basketball philosophies require great athletes.
On the left side. From the top of the circle, knocks it down. Look to get it to the inside. Jumper, goaltending called. Let's take another look at this deep three. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
From the corner, they can't stop this guy, Dick.
We'll have to give him a try, Brad.
If only my knees weren't aching. Tries for two, for the bucket, rebound out. On the right side, turnaround jumper, off the mark. Cross court. He tries the jumper, missed the jumper. Allen receives the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. He buries it. Looking for a good shot. He tries to knock down the three. He's just not seeing the floor, Dick.
He doesn't want to, Brad. He wants to score, and I'll tell you, that ain't good for team morale, baby.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Sinks the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. puts up the tray. Can't connect. Pushes it up. Johnson receives the ball, takes his jumper, gets the J to fall. Cross court. Turnaround jumper. The missed shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. About 6 minutes remaining in the game clock. Goes up for two. The shot won't fall. Out on the wing. Here's the three ball. Off the mark. Allen handles the feed.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Let's watch the move as he works his man, and now the fadeaway jumper goes. For the bucket, drains the shot. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
I tell you, he's really attacking the goal. He's going in fearless, and he's absolutely attacking the defense.
From way outside. Jumper won't go. Pushes it up. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Nails the sweet jumper. The Blue Devils are going to probably switch up their style here and play mainly in the half court, especially now since they've got the lead.
Hey, knowing when to settle down in the half court is very important. When you have the lead and the clock is winding down, the offensive goal should be to have longer possession.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Second shot, good. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
They've got them trapped. Man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Great job of containing the man there, Brian.
Gave it up. About 10 seconds left in the shot clock. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
Fires away.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Fans are open. Why'd he throw it to him? James makes his first substitution.
I'll tell you what I like about him, Brad. He brings all kinds of energy to the floor. Bad decision there by the freshman.
Pushes it up. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts the three and come up short. 3 minutes left in the game clock. Now they work it around the perimeter. The Blue Devils can't afford to have him pick up too many more fouls. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Second shot, no good. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
My goodness, it's chaotic in here.
He comes away with it. Block shot. Out of bounds, and we're staying right here. Jefferson comes back out onto the floor.
Major swing in energy with him back on the floor, Brad.
Inside. Takes the jumper. Buries it. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
I call these ones knee knockers, Brad. Close games that can easily go down to the final second.
He goes up with it. Knocks it down. Cross court.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Tries for two. Rims out. About 2 minutes remaining. He shoots the jumper. They get it to go. 9 points is the difference now.
A difference that can change in a heartbeat if you ain't careful, Brad.
Goes up. Busts the jumper. Perimeter. Goes up for two. With a layup. On the outside. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Here comes a ball screen. 1 minute left to go. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? So they'll inbound on the near sideline. He unloads a three. Scorches the net with a J. Working around the perimeter. He fires away. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Messler. Horrible shot selection.
Moving it around the perimeter. From three-point territory. He drains the bucket. Looks to record his first minutes.
He provides nice push offensively and defensively for this bunch.
Back, The Blue Devils now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Hicks receives the ball. Gave it up. Great hustle. Cross court. Outside jumper. Scores it. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.